Okay, so for the very first segment of the program this morning, we are going to be reconnecting with our friend. He was here last week to talk about the Peak Performer Awards. So today, we're looking at how best to dig in much better on the best recipes for leadership in Africa. And we're looking at it from the Peak Performer angle. And joining me on the phone line this morning, Dr. Abiola Salami is the Editor-in-Chief of Peak Performer Africa. Dr. Salami, nice to have you. Good morning.
Thank you. Good morning. It's great to be here again.
Right. So last week, we started that conversation and we had a very, very good time out, you know, speaking with you and the Peak Performer organization, yes. So to say. So how are things faring with your organization since last week?
Yes, going well, going fine. Yesterday, we hosted hundreds of young people to commemorate the 2024 International Youth Day to an event we called Emerge.
Right.
Emerge 2024.
And how did it
go? Helping them. Oh, it was phenomenal. Well attended. We had hundreds of young people came from all over. From Lagos, people came from outside Lagos.
Wow.
You know, from the neighboring states, Ogun State, Oyo State. You know, people came from neighboring states to be a part of it. The speakers were on fire. The speakers were also young people. Mm. So it's a peer-to-peer mentorship, you know, as it were.
Which is
young people, you know, who are doing their best, who are not allowing excuses to stop them from delivering greatness.
Mm.
You know, and then they came together. I mean, we all came together. I mean, the young people were sharing their stories, you know, on stage. All the young people in the audience were gaining insights,
right,
you know, useful for them. And of course, I was there too, to share Peak Performance insights,
great,
you know, with everyone. It was such a wonderful, wonderful event.
Wonderful, wonderful. That's great. So let's talk about Peak Performer. And of course, as we gradually draw our perhaps inch closer and closer to your event that is coming up, is the Peak Performer,
yes,
recognition and festival, right? Or what's it called?
Yes, it's the Peak Performer Festival. We call it TPP Fest.
Okay.
And what's happening in TPP Fest is a three-day event that focuses on serving each of the demography we commit to serving. One is emerging leaders. Emerging leaders are young people. We don't use the word youth.
Mm.
We use the word emerging leaders to start to give young people a sense of responsibility that,
okay,
you don't just exist as a young person, you exist as a young person who has the capacity to make greatness happen for the nation, whether you are in office or not. So emerging leaders. And then, so day one, that is 18th of September, is dedicated to these young people, equipping them with emotional intelligence to use that to drive a culture of peak performance.
Mm.
Day two of the festival is dedicated to women in leadership. So whether the woman is leading 1,000 people or she's leading just 2 people, wherever she is, that day two is dedicated to her. So whether she's an entrepreneur, she's a career professional, or she's a politician,
mm,
or she's a civil servant, whoever she is, so far she's leading people anywhere, day two is dedicated to her. And so we'll be equipping that woman with how to use emotional intelligence to improve her leadership, right? And day three, which is the grand finale,
mm-hmm,
you know, is the day for the awards, the Peak Performer Awards, where we're recognizing leaders in three categories.
Okay.
We're recognizing emerging leaders who are great examples to inspire all of us. We are recognizing women, peak performing women, you know, who are also great examples, inspirational for other women. And we are recognizing senior leaders across the public and private sector organizations, you know, who are showing exemplary leadership in the way they do what they do.
Right.
You know, so it's a really packed one. And by the way, while the event is holding in Lagos, Nigeria,
mm-hmm,
it is not limited to Nigeria because we are hosting emerging and senior leaders from across the continent.
Okay, so we'll talk about that. We'll talk about that. But is this the first time you're holding this festival?
Well, this is the first time we're doing it this way. Before now, We've had snippets of it, like last year, for example, we had the Peak Performing Woman of the Year 2023 that was well attended by women from across the continent, you know, not just Nigeria. While it's held in Lagos, Nigeria, you know, you had women from Ghana, from Kenya, from South Africa, from all over the place, you know, that were part of it. So this is not the first time we're hosting this event, but it's the first time we're serving everybody together, because one of our goals this year is inclusion. So you include everyone in the same conversation. We have young people, emerging leaders, we have women, and we have very senior leaders. Right. Everyone together, working with them to drive a culture of peak performance.
Which is very, very good. But you talk about the fact that it's not limited to Nigeria, that is extending to other African countries. Talk about that.
Yes. Yes, because our goal is not just to transform Lagos and Nigeria. Our goal is to impact the entire continent. Our goal is to, from Lagos, to touch the world. And what we are doing is to make sure that every black person on this continent is fully equipped to deliver peak performance, to deliver excellence with their skills and their talents. So we give them knowledge, we provide platforms for expression for them and growth. And so it is continental wide. We have other interventions that we even take to other parts of the continent. You know, earlier in the year, we were in Mombasa, Kenya, for example, for what we call the Dr. Abiola Salami International Leadership Bootcamp. Later on in the year, in October, we're going to Marrakesh, Morocco, North Africa, for another edition of the Dr. Abiola Salami International Leadership Bootcamp. It is because our core focus is on this continent. And we believe that if this continent gets it right, if we are all equipped to deliver peak performance, we will truly change the world. We will take over the world. And that is our commitment to every African listening to me right now.
All right. So Peak Performer Africa is on. But the very, very crucial part of this is the award ceremonies, right?
Yes, yes, yes.
So how can people partake in this award ceremony? What's the criteria for nominating someone?
Okay, so there is a website, www.tppafrica.com, tppafrica.com. Now, when you visit this website, you will see the full details on nomination. We're expecting nominations in three categories: Peak Performing Emerging Leader of the Year, Peak Performing Woman of the Year, and Peak Performing Senior Leader of the Year. All the criteria is right there. And by the way, it's important for us to know that in our organization, we are not popularity centered. We are credibility centered.
What does that mean?
Meaning that this is not about... Okay, it means this is not about voting for people. You know, there are some platforms that will say, oh, vote for whoever you think is best. No, we are not doing voting. It's about credibility. The tangible things that we can see that the person has contributed to their community or to their industry.
Right.
To their community or to their industry. You know, and because we need to shine the light on the right people. One of the things working against us as a continent is that we don't shine the light on the right people. We don't shine the light on the people with the right values, so that we can see possibilities that are available around us. So, not everybody is corrupt.
Right.
Not everybody is indolent. Not everybody is stealing. There are people who have the right values and are doing great. And those are the people we are spotlighting.
All right. So how would you know? I mean, if I nominate someone and I put there all his resume and everything, how are you able to determine if what I put there is true?
Well, because we have our way of finding out. We have our way of checking, of double, triple checking. You know, so give us the resume. We have our way of finding out. And when we find out, when we see anything that does not align with our values, we don't publish the person.
All right. So there's some messages that are coming in for you. This one says, Dr. Salami, I would like to know what is the process for nominating someone for the Peak Performer Awards. Cheers, Yinka. I think you just talked about that. This one says, good morning, Traffic Radio. This one says, good morning, Traffic Radio. In your own opinion, what distinguishes the Peak Performer Awards from other similar events? You didn't put your name, by the way. All right. So, Dr. Salami, what makes your own unique?
Okay, well, I won't be talking about what makes us different, you know, from other platforms? Because our focus is on deepening what we're doing. And perhaps one of the things which I said earlier is about credibility. We are more of credibility, not popularity. We are looking for people, you know, who have the competence, the character, the creativity, the compassion and courage to make a positive difference, you know, where they are. And for us, we're not just spotlighting leaders. We spotlight leaders and we equip leaders. So it's not just about the jamboree and the fun fair, right? We also afterwards still subject people, you know, to a process of development and growth.
Right.
You know, so spotlighting is one thing and that's not the end to it. You know, and we've done the work of growth and development over the past 12 years in this country and across other countries, equipping leaders, training them to deliver excellence. And we have loads of testimonials, you know, on the leaders that we're equipping with emotional intelligence, leaders we're equipping with driving a culture of peak performance. And those are the things that we're bringing to our society to equip more leaders so that they can deliver the transformation that we seek.
All right. This one says, good morning, Victor. I'm just joining the conversation. How can businesses or individuals take part or support the peak performer? Okay, so
great.
I'm just joining this. Wait, so how can businesses or individuals take part in or support the Peak Performer Awards and Festival? Chidi from Ikrodu sending that one in. So, do you also entertain people supporting you?
Sure. I mean, we can't do this alone. You know, we can't do this alone. There's a Yoruba saying that says Igi ko le dagboshe, meaning that one tree doesn't make a forest.
Okay.
So we can't do this alone. Depend on the support of well-meaning people. So for anyone listening that wants to support, just send us an email to team@tppafrica.com. That is T-E-A-M, team@tppafrica.com. And we'll be glad to, you know, to reach out to you to let you know the modalities on how we can make this happen together.
All right, then. So I'm hoping that this is going to be another great event of the year that will lovely people talking and talking. By the time we're getting close to the event itself, we'll have you back. And then you can talk to us what the lineup would look like. Maybe we'll have some great entertainers that will be there as well. Some soccer stars or sports celebrities and all of that. Let's round this up right now. Dr. Salami, what's your parting thought to our listeners on the program this morning?
So what I want to say for every one of us, let us know that the change we seek is in the palms of our hands. The transformation we seek, nobody is coming from outside to rescue us. Each of us, we have to roll our sleeves and start to work to make our communities better. The responsibility is for every one of us.
All right. That's a great one indeed. Dr. Abiola Salami, thank you so much for connecting with us on the program this morning.
Thank you so much for having me. Thank you.
Okay, so we'll be trying to look at how best to dig into the recipe for effective leadership, and we're doing that from the perspective of Peak Performer Africa. We're going to switch gears right now. Birthday Profile is next on the menu. Keep it locked.